Dear colleagues, this talk will be the second addiction lecture actually in this pandemic area. My name is Sándor Fekete and I will present this addiction illegal drugs and some review regarding the behavioral addiction. So, addiction to in medicine it's somehow a chronic neurobiological disorder with clinical, genetic, psychosocial, environmental dimension characterized by the following: continued use of the substance, illegal drugs despite damaging effect, impaired control over the use of drug, it's used compulsively. No control in spite of the damaging effect. Maybe not only damaging, but maybe lethal and dangerous effect of the compounds. But it's also important the preoccupation with the drug's use, craving after drug for non-therapeutic causes. Addiction can be purposes. Addiction can be behavioral addiction too. What are these illegal drugs? These are psychoactive substances. These are compounds that alter one's states of mind, and is rewarded, and after that neuroadaptation reward this process. Considering the background, let me summarize the typical causes, reasons behind genetic background and vulnerability, neurobiological vulnerability is one. Second one is a primary or secondary diagnosis, dual diagnosis, especially the at least half of the illegal drug users, dependent people, dependency might be the biggest problem in our society. Dual diagnosis, and the depressive, anxious, aggressive patients start to use so-called self-medication. So they try to alleviate their symptoms, but because of the neuroadaptation later, step by step, using illegal drugs, step by step, addiction will be created, unfortunately. So not only the primary mental diagnosis, but also secondary addiction dependency diagnosis will be seen. So-called self-medication model. The third, after the biological model, dual diagnosis, disease model, so-called psychological, social causes. We can find culture prescribed, tolerated habits, availability, individual traits, group impacts. Regarding the terminology, it's important, it's illegal drugs, legal drugs we can say about alcohol, nicotine. Actually, Professor Tényi presented for you in addiction one, the alcohol-related psychiatric problem, this addiction two, so illegal drugs and behavioral addiction, these brain-altering substances. Addiction means somehow dependency, tolerance, withdrawal. Somebody wants to stop it, actually is not possible because of the physical, psychological withdrawal symptoms, and they need it even if it's damaging. It affects the functionality, of course, the jobs, the achievement, the family relationships too. So actually they live in a artificial world instead of a real world. What are these illegal drugs? According to NIDA, the American Center, some years ago was formulated, of course, in this group we can find the concept, early known drugs like heroin, opiates, cocaine, inhalants, marijuana, LSD. the new drugs, new group is actually synthetic molecules, synthetic compounds, synthetic marijuana maybe, or these so-called designer drugs that are more dangerous, more lethal, more damaging compared to the conservative earlier used drugs. Of course, we have stimulants, we have sedative, also medications which can be addicted. Considering the evaluation, it's possible to see them in moral, in legal, economical, medical, scientific way. Which is a very important research area recently, the neurobiological aspect, maybe the inherited low opioid production in the midbrain and dysregulation of specific mechanisms, especially the rewarding neurocircuitry and the consequent neuroadaptation stabilize these bad circles. The genetic studies support this neurobiological approach. Of course, the psychological games and psychological family problems, interpersonal traits play an important role, also the cultural aspects. We can have some criteria of substance dependence, substance intoxication, tolerance. In DSM-5 we have these illegal drugs, but some of the behavioral addictions, especially the gambling disorder, we have maybe a smatter for other behavioral addictions, sex addiction or phone, smartphone, internet addiction. This might be metaphors. It's not very easy in study researches. It's formulated as internet-related pathology, related pathology addiction. Maybe not very easy to distinguish what is pathological, what is maybe extreme normal. If somebody will lose all the social relationships of the jobs at achievement, just the virtual world is important for him, this is psychopathological. I think those behavioral forms are behavioral addictions. But we see the biggest group, actually the illegal drugs. There are differences between the dependence addiction potential. So there are drugs with very high dependence potential, namely heroin, crack cocaine, morphine, opium. There are moderately addictive compounds. Unfortunately, tobacco and alcohol belong to this group, also benzos, some medications, and amphetamines, moderately low addictive potential, have some amphetamines, marijuana, ketamine, and very low without physical withdrawal effect, LSD, and mushrooms, psilocybin, mescaline, for example. Otherwise, you know, addictive drug dependencies, if they stop taking medication, they after tolerance period, there will be very serious, there can be very serious withdrawal physical symptoms. We have to treat them because it can be life threatening. Of course, the very serious forms of disorders, shape is a little bit smaller for recreational use. Much more people use these different drugs. Regarding the dependence and tolerance, we can say a lot of unsuccessful efforts to cut down, to control, but no control, great time to spend it. Important activities are given up. Might be the DSM-5 doesn't distinguish so sharply the tolerance, withdrawal, dependency, and serious abuse. However, in clinical life, we see tolerance more and more, illegal drugs needed for a balance, or withdrawal after cessation of using drugs. We can see serious physical and psychological symptoms. Psychological is important, the loss of control. They try to control the drug use, but they are not able to control it. They try to use the denial, a psychological mechanism. However, it's the powerless over time. Pathological passion is seen. The addictions, dependencies regarding illegal drugs and behavioral drugs have some historical aspects, sociological, of course, psychological, biological, a lot of research in empirical area. We can see the classical, again, heroin opiates, cocaine, ecstasy, hallucinogenics, and the design, maybe the recently the most dangerous, the designer drugs. You can find it also a lecture by Dr. Heinal about the new designer drug problems. How to treat them? This is the most difficult problem. We have psychosocial, classical psychosocial treatment in this area, the cognitive therapies might be group and family therapies are useful, and self-help groups, NA, Narcotics Anonymous, Gamblers Anonymous, these are very similar in functionality in the AA, Alcoholics Anonymous. There are some medication we can give, we are able to give opiate partial agonist, buprenorphine, antagonist in an extreme life-threatening situation, naltrexone. Of course, we have, in case of marijuana, CB1 receptor antagonists regarding benzos, some medication. In the research, dopaminergic, serotonergic areas, GABA areas are studied, even epigenetics importance is very important. Let me finish again with a short term, with the sentences. The short term treat is a tactic treat in pharmacological and psychological treat of the acute withdrawal situation, later to save the stabilized situation, to prevent the new relapses. We have drug ambulances, rehabilitation institution with long lasting, very structured therapy and self help groups. Thank you very much.